Hey everyone, thanks for tuning into CryptoZX. I really appreciate you stopping by my channel today. To all my viewers watching my video right now, can I please ask you guys to smash that like button and hit the red subscribe button if you haven't already. This does help out the channel tremendously and it also keeps me motivated on making videos for you guys. But with that being said, let's jump right into today's content. Alright guys, before I begin, I would like to say the disclaimer. Anything on this channel should not be taken as financial advice because I am not a financial advisor. Cryptocurrencies are super volatile, so please do your own due diligence and research before investing in these markets. Looking at the overall crypto market cap today, you guys can see we are currently sitting at $2.7 trillion. We are down 3.2% in the last 24 hours. Meanwhile, BTC dominance is currently sitting at 40.4%. Looking at the overall markets, guys, we are starting to see once again a little bit more red across the board, especially in the last 24 hours. And that's once again mainly due to the fact that Bitcoin is seeing some price volatility occurring within its price. But again, one thing to point out for you guys is that, you know, today is the weekend. We are coming to an end. And if you guys don't know, we do tend to see a lot of manipulation occur on the weekends because, you know, CME futures are closed. So we do tend to see the markets manipulated. Like I have mentioned before in my videos, I do take the price action on the weekends with the grain of salt. But today I want to talk about none other than one coin, and that is VeChain. All right, my VeChain family, if we are looking at the VeChain price right now, not much has happened since yesterday. We are currently trading at 12.9 cents. We are down 5.2% in the last 24 hours in USD comparative. We're also down 2.4% in Bitcoin comparative over the last 24 hours. One thing that has changed since yesterday is that we have dropped, down to that 24 spot compared to the 23 spot that we were ranked at just yesterday. So currently we are ranked at top 24. Market cap right now is $8.6 billion. And the 24-hour trading volume is at $539.7 million. Zooming out and looking at the bigger picture, guys, in just the last year alone, we're still up 800%. So let's not forget that when we are looking at the prices of VeChain. But now let's get into the exciting stuff and see what's happening with the VeChain's price and where we could be going in the immediate short term. So right off the bat, guys, you guys can see VeChain is still hanging around this 61.8 Fibonacci retracement level. And one thing that we want to see right now is that you guys can see this level of support is playing out for us at this 13 cents mark. We are right now just a little below it. But as you guys can see, we have wicked down below it two times, but we managed to break above it every single time. So it should not be coming as a surprise to you guys that we are hovering around this level once again. I do expect us to get back into back above this level very, very fast as Bitcoin has a reversal as well. Because right now, if we are looking at the Bitcoin price right now, guys, you guys can see Bitcoin is breaking towards the downside once again. We did go all the way down to $55,000 just 2 days ago, and there's still a possibility for us to go back down to that level and revisit that. So that's why we are seeing VeChain reacting as well, along with the entire cryptocurrency markets. And what I personally would want VeChain to do is to stay above this level, guys. As long as we stay above this level, I am happy and everything is looking good. But one thing we cannot be forgetting right now is that, you know, Bitcoin is seeing more downwards momentum right now, so we need to keep that in mind. So let's not be unrealistic and think it's just VeChain that's going down. It's the entire market that is going down right now. Even after having this dip, guys, just since September 28th, VeChain is still up 57%, guys. 57%. Now, this might not sound crazy to most of us, because, you know, we have been seeing meme coins and some of the altcoins flying absolutely insane, 1,000% over the past couple months. But we need to keep in mind, guys, every coin has its moment, and meme coins right now are the ones that are super, super hyped due to the fact that, you know, Dogecoin and SHIB, that really kickstarted a lot of hype within the meme coin. And that market itself, guys, that side of the market is very, 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 very risky, guys, because you never know when that will plunge. And you never know. I've seen so many meme coins. I've heard so many stories that a certain meme coin came out, everyone went crazy on it, and boom, they just exit scammed. And that's the risk, guys. Yes, you could make crazy gains over there, but the risk is absolutely insane there. So I strongly encourage you guys to stay away from the meme coins, but you guys do what works for you. If you guys want to play it, that's all up to you, but I would not invest money that I cannot afford to lose, guys. I cannot stress that enough. Projects like VeChain, guys, the projects with real utility, strong fundamentals are here to stay. Yes, we are not seeing crazy price actions that everyone wants to see, but guys, the time is coming. Let's not forget what type of market we are in right now. Yes, this might sound to you guys right now, oh my God, we're seeing crazy drops happening within the VeChain's price. But let's not forget, guys, this right here, Bitcoin. Let me repeat again, Bitcoin is the king of the cryptocurrency markets. And Bitcoin is, like I said, it's the king. So the entire cryptocurrency market is highly correlated with the Bitcoin price. And historically speaking, when Bitcoin sees downwards momentum, we do tend to see altcoins get hit even harder. And that's something I know a lot of newcomers are not grasping to that fact. But, you know, that's something that we really need to start accepting and understanding how Bitcoin and altcoins are strongly correlated with one another. And right now, guys, you guys can see something very interesting is happening with the Bitcoin price. And let me explain as to what exactly that is. You guys can see we came all the way down to 55,000 and we saw a beautiful bounce back towards the upside. But this time around, as you guys can see, something very interesting is going on. We went all the way up to that $6,200 level that I've been talking about. It is playing as a level of resistance right now. We touched it and boom, got rejected. So that's something to keep in mind. We do need more buying pressure coming in for the Bitcoin price in order for us to smash past the 6,200 level and stay above there. As you guys may know, I have said that in my previous video, I would like Bitcoin to stay above this level at all costs. But time is going to tell as we, you know, finish this weekend. It's already Monday somewhere around the world, not in North America right now. It is midnight, but somewhere around the world, it's already, you know, Monday. And I do strongly believe that this coming, you know, week, we might see Bitcoin rebouncing above this level of resistance. But we will see. So something that should not be ignored, guys. We need to keep a very, very close eye on this. And Bitcoin dominance, something is happening right now. We are seeing Bitcoin dominance hover around that 43% to 44%. And still nothing crazy happening. But if Bitcoin... Now, let me tell you guys two case scenarios that could happen. If Bitcoin decides to see more downward trend occurring within the Bitcoin's price, we could see the shoot up, guys. So this could really affect altcoins in the immediate short term. And if Bitcoin starts having its rally again, which I have been saying that Bitcoin still has quite a bit of steam left if we are above that $6,300 level, we could still see this Bitcoin dominance index going up. And if you guys don't know what Bitcoin dominance is, basically the percentage of money in the overall market, you know, in Bitcoin. And right now, 42.97% is right now in Bitcoin. So as higher this number goes, the more altcoins lag behind Bitcoin's price. But right now, I like where BTC dominance is sitting, but we should be prepared for the fact that this could rise if two of these events were to occur. But when it comes to VeChain, guys, nothing to worry about. Let me repeat that again. Nothing to worry about, especially if you are in it for the long haul. We are still aiming for newer all-time highs this year, guys. Let me repeat it again. Me personally, I am still aiming for newer all-time highs for VeChain. We're still in Q4. Markets are still extremely bullish. And, you know, this is just a beautiful, you know, healthy correction that we are seeing right now occur within the markets, which is very much needed. And the time is coming when we do see reversal. So just stay patient, guys. Hodl on. If you're in for the long haul, it doesn't really matter. These kind of price corrections, it does not matter at all. When we see dips, we dollar cost average in and, you know, make our holdings bigger and bigger. You know, patience is the key. And when you do see crazy gains, guys, it's not only about VeChain. If you are seeing massive, massive gains in certain altcoins that you have invested, you know, you always want to be asking yourself question, hey, is that too much money that I cannot afford to lose, guys? If the answer is yes, you know, it's best that you lock in some profits. So when these kind of dips do occur, then, you know, you reaccumulate and make your holdings bigger. But that's just my personal strategy. You guys do what works for you. But what I would like VeChain to do currently is to stay above this level. I do see it bouncing back up very, very easily. and possibly try to get back into this 0.50 very, very fast. But that is not going to happen unless we do see Bitcoin revisit this level of resistance and smash past it. So we need to keep that part in mind as well. But that is it for today's update, guys. Let me know in the comment section below, what are you guys doing right now? And where are you guys thinking VeChain is headed till the end of this year? Leave in the comment section below. I would love to know your thoughts down below. And if I can ask you guys for one favor, that is if you can like, comment, and subscribe. That's literally all I ask for. And that would mean the absolute world to me. And before I end this video, guys, I want to say thank you so much for all the support that you guys are showing me. Each and every one of you guys, I love you all. You guys have been absolutely killing it with the support. And always remember, your support does not go unnoticed. I'm going to keep doing this for you guys. And CryptoZX channel, mark my word, we are going to the top. We're going to 100K and above. So keep supporting me, and we are going to the moon together. But stay safe out there, guys, because at the end of the day, safety is the most important thing. Family is the most important. Everything else absolutely comes later. Let's not forget that. Let's always keep in mind what's more important in life. We do tend to forget about that stuff. So let's not forget about that kind of stuff. I will see you guys tomorrow. Love you all once again. Thank you so much for the support. I will see you guys tomorrow. It's been CryptoZX, and peace out.